Hey, what's up? This is Randy. Today we're going to learn to scale functions. But what does it really mean to scale a function? One way you could think about it is when we scale a function, we are either stretching the curve or compressing the curve. Let's do this. So we're going to start today by talking about how to scale a function vertically, and then we'll talk about how to scale a function horizontally, and then at the end we will do a couple of examples to practice what we learned. Remember to always pause it before I go through the process on the examples so that you can try it yourself first. Okay, how do we scale functions vertically? This description is going to look kind of crazy at first, but then we'll break it down. So it says, given f of x, k times f of x will cause every y value on the graph to be multiplied by the value k, with each corresponding x value remaining unchanged. But what is this really saying? Let's use the example of this graph, f of x equals x squared minus 2x minus 1. Now, g of x right here and k of x are a couple of examples of f of x that has been scaled in different ways. So what did we do to f of x to get g of x? You can see that the only difference is that we multiplied the entire function by 2, right? So you can see now that k is 2 in this case. And then in this next example, we just multiplied the entire function by 1/2. So k is 1/2, right? Okay, that's progress, because now we know what is k in the function g of x, and we know what is k in the function k of x. Now, what is the significance of k? It says that k times f of x will cause every y value on the graph to be multiplied by the value k. Okay, so let's just choose a point on this graph, and then we'll see what happens to the y value. And before I do that, let me just be really clear that the green curve on this graph is still just f of x. I put it there again so that we can see the change more easily. And once again, the green curve here came from f of x. So when I say g of x, it's really referring to the blue curve. And when I say k of x, once again, it's referring to the blue curve. I just put the f of x there again so that we can see the change more easily. All right, so I chose to use the vertex on both of these curves. So the vertex on the green curve is 1, negative 2. And the vertex on the blue curve is 1, negative 4. Make sure that you use the corresponding point on each graph. You know, for example, I can't use the vertex here on the green curve and then all of a sudden use this point up here on the blue curve. We need to use corresponding points. So vertex and vertex. Now you'll see in this vertical scaling, what did not change? Just like it says up here, the x value remains unchanged. You can see that the x value here is 1 and it's still 1 after the vertical scaling. So just like it says up here, the x value did not change. But what did change? The y value. In f of x, the y value at the vertex was negative 2, right? And then it became negative 4 after multiplying the entire function by 2. Now, in this lesson, you're only going to see k's that are positive. So what happens when we multiply f of x by 2? We get a vertical stretch, right? The green parabola all of a sudden stretched up and down in order to become the blue parabola. All right, so that's what happens when k is more than 1. We get a vertical stretching. But what if k is between 0 and 1? Like in this case, we have k as 1/2. What do you think will happen? Well, as you can see, the green curve all of a sudden becomes compressed to become that blue curve. So let's find some easy point to select so that we can see how much it got compressed. I would say let's just use the vertices again. So there's the vertex on f of x, and there's the vertex on k of x. So once again, going from f of x to k of x, the x values did not change. We had 1 for f of x and 1 for k of x. But in f of x, the y value at the vertex was negative 2, and then it became negative 1. So what happened to the y value? It became multiplied by 1/2, right? all we did is take this y value from f of x, negative 2, and multiply it by the k, which was 1 half. So I put times 1 half right here. And what did we get? We got negative 1, which is that new y value after the scaling. The same exact logic applied on g of x, right? We started with the green curve here. So the y value was negative 2. And then we said times 2, because 2 is k, equals negative 4, which is the new y value after the scaling. All right, now, if you think that you understand this really well, don't get too overly confident, because horizontal scaling is a little bit more counterintuitive. Let's read it together. Given f of x, now we have f of k times x will cause every x value, notice x value, not y value, on the graph to be divided by the value k, with each corresponding y value remaining unchanged. Okay, real quick, what is f of k times x saying? It's just saying that we replace x with something times x. So here, we had x, and then we replaced it with 2x in both places where x was, right? And then in k of x, we replaced x with 1 half x and 1 half x. That's what k times x means. So in g of x, k is just this 2, so k equals 2. And then in k of x, the k is just the 1 half. And once again, just so that we're all clear, the blue curve here is really the g of x, and the blue curve here is the k of x. I just put the green curve, which is f of x, in both of these so that we can see the scaling a little bit more easily. All right, so once again, let's pick a point on the green curve. We'll pick this point right here, negative 1, 1. And then a corresponding point on the blue curve, which is at negative 0.5, 1. And then we'll analyze what happened when we went from f of x to g of x. So this time, the x value in f of x went from negative 1 to negative 1 half in g of x. And we can see that the y values stay the same, 1 and 1. Okay, now think about this. What did we do to the x value in f of x on the green curve in order to get the x value of g of x on the blue curve? We divided this first x value by k. We divided by 2. So original x value divided by our k, which we got from that number in front of x in both cases, equals negative 1 half, which is our new x value. Now pay very close attention here, because when we were scaling functions vertically, this word was not divided, it was multiplied. So vertical scaling, multiply. Horizontal scaling, divide. All right, now let's see what happens in this k of x. All right, here are the two corresponding points I chose. And just as we would expect, the y value, which was 1 and 1, did not change, just like we learned up here that it would not. But the x value went from negative 1 to negative 2. So we just did negative 1 divided by k, or divided by 1 half, in order to get negative 2. Now, what's another way that you could write negative 1 divided by 1 half? You could just say negative 1 times 2. That's the same thing. And either way, that gives us negative 2 for our new x value. So when we scale functions horizontally, we just divide the original x value by k, and that gives us the new x value. All right, let's apply all this with a couple of quick examples. All right, like I mentioned before, remember to pause the video now and try it yourself, and then we'll do it together. All right, given the equation for the green curve, f of x, write the equation for the blue curve, g of x. Okay, so once again, we're starting with the green curve. I would say let's just choose the vertex because that's pretty easy. So we'll choose this point and this point and see what happened. Okay, now that we can see that this is a vertical scaling, what do we do to the equation when we vertically scale it? We multiply the entire equation by something, which we call k, right? So we need to find out what is k in this example. So we know that with vertical scaling, the y values change. So here's one y value, and here's another y value. So basically, we need to ask the question, negative 1 times what gave us negative 2? That what is our k. So here's how that equation would look. Now, negative 1 times what is negative 2? Obviously, negative 1 times 2. So 2 is our k. All right, so g of x is just this entire function times k, or times 2. So they asked us to write the equation for the blue curve, g of x, and that's it. G of x is equal to 2 times x squared minus 1. All right, one more example, but this time with a horizontal scaling. Given the equation for the green curve, f of x, write the equation for the blue curve, g of x. Okay, so it looks like we have a compression. It went from this curve to this curve. And you'll notice that the vertex does not change from the green curve to the blue curve. So we cannot choose the vertex for our test. Let's choose this point and this point. So we want to figure out, how did we go from 1, 0 to 0.5, 0, or 1/2, 0? We know that with horizontal scaling, we will replace our x with something times x. So what is that something? What is k? So we need to ask the question, this x value 1 divided by what gave us this x value, 1/2. Now remember, to get every new x value, when we scale functions horizontally, we divide each x value by k. So once again, that's why we say 1 divided by what gives us 1/2. Well, obviously, 1 divided by 2 gives us 1/2. So k is 2 in this case. Now, how do we write that in the equation if k is 2? We're going to replace every x with k times x, so 2x. And in this case, we had just x squared, but no other terms with x. So instead of writing x squared, we wrote 2x squared. 2x is k times x. We still have minus 1 right here. So we needed to write the equation for the blue curve, g of x, and there it is. G of x is equal to 2x all squared minus 1. That's our answer. All right, now that we have learned to scale functions vertically using k times f of x as a template, and to scale functions horizontally using f of k times x as a template, we are finished. See you next time.